But today I've had a visit to a fishing camp in Terekeka, and it's been a most useful experience, not only to get out of Juba and to look at the challenges which meet ordinary South Sudanese, but to see a very successful project in which real livelihoods are being created for ordinary South Sudanese. And I think there's a broad recognition that in South Sudan there can't be peace without development, but we know that there can't be development without peace. And in a sense, this county represents a real attempt to ground peace, but also a project in which the fruits of peace can be felt by all the people.
South Sudan is one of the fortunate countries in the world with a very long river line. So given that, you find that the challenge that the South Sudanese have and the population of Terekeka has is to extend the shelf life of the fish. They used to get fish in the morning, and by evening, whatever they don't sell, it is just thrown out. And so we are introducing drying skins so that the fish can take up to 8 months. Before that, it could only take 24 hours and at max 48 hours. So with that technology and with the processing technology, we hope that they are able to get value for money.
So there's a number of reasons why it's important. One of them is that the vessels that they make are using a very old technique before with tar, and they're not sealed very well. So they typically, water comes into the vessel and water is absorbed in the wood. The vessels become very heavy and inefficient. So by using contemporary materials like epoxy resin and fiberglass, we make a boat that lasts longer by a long way. It's lighter. It's easy to move through the water and cheaper and uses less gasoline.
I think communities which take the future into their own hands, become, as it were, masters of their own destiny, become examples to other communities across South Sudan.
Give us my